As with the other activities, the students will be divided into six different task groups addressing one of the six different types of concerns raised by citizens. This activity will focus mainly on the night sky issues that were on this poster. In order for the students to understand the problems under this section, they'll need a bit of background information found on the light pollution and night sky poster. This poster includes the problems of sky glow, how light is wasted through sky glow, and how sky glow is detrimental to our cultural heritage and observatories and astronomers everywhere. If students want to do more research on sky glow, they can look up the key ideas on the internet. Also on the poster is an introduction to the activities they'll be performing in this activity. The materials required for the night sky activity are found in the night sky Ziploc container, the night sky star projector, and the aluminum foil, which the students can use later on in the activity. The posters involving the night sky activity are also found in the posters tube. In the case that the night sky star projector is faulty, we also provide a backup star projector that should look something like this. It is found here under all the Ziploc containers, and the instructions for assembly is found in the instructor's guide envelope. The first activity will be set up as follows. The two pieces of black construction paper will be fastened to the table lengthwise. On one end of the two pieces of construction paper will be the night sky star projector. About 15 inches from the star projector, or roughly 39 centimeters, will be our globe light. To set up the globe light, simply uncap the mag light and attach the ping pong ball to the top of it. The cap can also be used as a base for the globe light to help it stand better. Above the star projector should be a standard piece of 8x11 inch paper held roughly 3 inches above the star projector. I've drawn a circle on here to outline where the star should be on the paper. The setup for the second part of the activity is similar to the first, but it also involves different types of lights and materials the students can use to try and solve the problems of sky glow. You are also free to use any kind of objects you might find at home or in the classroom for the students to experiment with. To start the first activity, you will begin by having the students record the number of stars in the night sky when there are no other lights present. To help with this, if you have a transparency, you can cut it out to the shape of the top of the projector and divide it into four quadrants. With this, you can count the number of stars in one quadrant and multiply by four to get the total number of stars in the night sky. Once you have the total number of stars in the night sky recorded, introduce the globe light to the scene. Start it at 15 inches and ask the students to record the number of stars they see with a percentage. Are there 75% of stars visible, 50%, and so on. As you move it closer and closer to the projector, ask the kids to record the percentage of stars they see as well as the distance associated with that percentage. When you are finished recording all the data, ask them to draw conclusions from the data. As it gets closer to the star projector, do the stars become easier or harder to see? This represents why observatories are built further away from cities and atop mountains, so they can reduce the effect of sky glow. Introduce the second part of the activity as follows. With the globe light next to the projector, ask the students to observe what they see. Then, remove the globe light from the scene and introduce the book light. Ask the students to compare the differences between the book light and the globe light. Clearly, the book light is better than the globe light. Ask the students why this is. When they reach the conclusion that it's because the light of the book light is pointing downwards, then ask them to form something from the materials given that will direct the light of the globe light downwards. The students may come up with something like this. Something that will guide the light downwards instead of into the night sky. When they reach that conclusion, introduce the black PVC cap into the scene to demonstrate their solution. This is known as light shielding. With proper light shielding, people can still see the night sky in its full glory whilst being in a residential area. To demonstrate the effectiveness of proper light shielding, you can repeat the first experiment, but include the PVC cap as well. Again, ask the students to record the visibility of the stars as you move the light closer and closer to the projector. The students should notice that with proper light shielding, proximity to the light does not affect the visibility of the stars in the night sky. You can also use the shields designed by the students to perform this experiment.